Hello everyone, my name is Don, the movie reviewer, and today we're going to be talking about a foreign language movie from a director I've never heard of before, Alejandro Jodorowsky. This movie's called Endless Poetry, and the only reason I wanted to check out this film is because I was at my local theater, the Lagoon Theater, fantastic theater for local movies, also major blockbusters, support your local indie movie theaters. I can't remember what movie I saw, I think it was Colossal or something else that I saw, and this trailer played before the movie that I actually went to go see. And you know, I encounter a lot of foreign language, you know, movie trailers every now and then, and I look at them and I say, oh, that looks interesting, but, you know, I saw Amelia and, you know, I was intrigued by that movie, but then after I saw that movie, I didn't really like it all that much. So I'm kind of usually iffy with foreign language movies, you know, if it captures my attention. With this, it immediately captured my attention from the preview that I saw. It looked very bizarre, very strange, very different. So I was immediately like interested in watching this movie from the first trailer that I saw. And movie came out, I watched it. Now here's my review. Enjoy.
¿Cuál es el sentido de la vida?
El cerebro hace preguntas, el corazón da las respuestas. La vida no tiene sentido. ¡Vive! ¡Vive!
Poesía, alumbrarás mi camino como una mariposa que arde.
¡Voy a ser poeta!
¡Te vas a morir de hambre!
¡Familia de mierda!
Endless Poetry is about Alejandro Jodorowsky's life story, an autobiography, if you will. It tells a story about his father shaming him for his love of poetry, from his mother constantly crying and singing all the time, from his relationships with his friends and his loved ones, from his endless love of poetry that takes him on a life's journey that is full of laughs, cries,
por amigo me odia. Soy un traidor. Me acosté con su novia. Quizás me pegó la sífilis. Quizás la pobre cayó encinta. La vida es un juego. Hay que reírse de todo, de lo peor. Ríanse. Ríanse.
Humor, betrayal, rejoice.
¿Ya no tienes corazón? ¿Todo te da igual? ¡Ya no sé quién eres! ¡Estás aquí metido en un nido de borrachos! ¡De degenerados! ¡Ya! ¡Me das asco!
¡Nos das asco!
¡Nos vamos a un hotel!
Quemó mi casa.
¡Qué maravilla!
Sorrow, wonder, nudity, violence, riding the crimson tide, and whatever other sort of wacky shit you can think of, it is in this movie. For starters, this movie breaks the fourth wall instantly. It sucks you into this world that's full of wonder and color. Think of the Amelia movie meets Tim Burton's Big Fish. It's living in bizarro land while maintaining a serious undertone. Bright colors captivate the screen, weird images hypnotize the mind with stagey and progressive storytelling, which delivers a sensational cinematic message that I think translates well beyond the screen to reach out and communicate with its intended audience. Would you dare follow your dreams? Would you listen to your parents if they told you that you couldn't follow your dreams? Would you rebel or rejoice in the fact that almost everyone around you follows the same conformity rules and they wanted you to do the exact same thing? Would you be your own person or fall victim to the endless parade of conformity rules around you? How many paths would you take in your life in order to create yourself? What roads would you go down in order to get to where you want it to be? Whatever the choice may be, the choice is yours to make alone. Nobody can make the choices for you. It's up to you to create yourself. Being your own person is what I think the message of this movie was trying to convey. I don't know how much of this is fiction and how much of this is nonfiction, but whatever the case may be, this movie is balls to the walls bananas. Endless scenes of absurdity fill the screen for extended periods of time. Now, usually this bothers me because I'm not into the bonkers fantasy type movies. Think of your Wes Anderson kind of movie. The Grand Budapest Hotel was okay though. What I'm saying is that these types of movies aren't my thing, and so I tend to stay away from them. But sometimes one of these movies comes along and takes my breath away. From the start, you immediately get sucked into this world of wonder and excitement. There's this underlying message to it that feels kind of preachy, but for some reason, it never feels forced. You can imagine a movie that tries to pound its message into your brain, but this movie never feels like it's doing that. Maybe because the message of the movie really resonated with me so much that I really didn't mind it if it was preachy at all. Maybe, I don't know. I thought a few things within this movie were a bit too extreme for me, but nonetheless, I had an overall great experience with this film. If you're the type of person who's not into seeing penises, naked ladies, sex with a woman while she's on her period, then this ain't the movie for you. Stay away from this film at all costs. Watching the main character's journey is an interesting one because of all of the absurdity that takes place in this movie. But with all that going on, there's also a humanity to this that I believe can resonate with an individual audience member, as maybe that individual audience member can relate to the main character's story. Adam Jodorowsky plays whom I think is his father, Alejandro Jodorowsky. He plays the adolescent version of him, and I thought his performance was phenomenal. He captured the essence of a man who had a vivid imagination, and all he wanted to do was share his insight with the world that was trying to tear him down. Jeremias Herskovitz plays the child version of Alejandro. He captures the light of a child that doesn't want to be destroyed by the negative forces that surround him. Neither one of these versions of Alejandro are saints. They do things that would be considered taboo in a civilized society. Some of the choices that the main character made upset me, but that's what life is. You make choices, and sometimes we make mistakes. But we also must remember that the choices we make can affect others around us. Brontis Jodorowsky plays Alejandro's father, and he's your be a doctor and make something of yourself kind of father. He doesn't want Alejandro to pursue his passion for poetry. He tries to make his son conform by constantly calling him names and telling him that he's never going to make it anywhere. You know, the usual kind of father who really doesn't want you to amount to your dreams and just kind of, just throws you down to the ground and then says, listen here, boy, you're going to be who I tell you to be because you're not going to embarrass me in front of my friends and family. You're going to conform and you're going to like it and you're going to do this. And then you conform and you're just like, oh yeah, I'm going to be that person, but then I don't want to be that person. I want to be my own person. So I'm trying to break out of my shell and I'm constantly having conflict with myself within my brain because I don't know which side I should go on. But then it's like, hey, just be yourself, man. Just be who you are because, hey, don't tell me what to do with my life. Pamela Flores plays two different characters in this movie. She plays Alejandro's girlfriend and his mother. Now, I didn't know that until I looked this movie up, and that is unbelievable to me because while I was watching the movie, I couldn't even tell. I thought the characters were two different people. Her performance was amazing. Her mother character sings throughout the entire movie. At first, I thought it was going to be a problem, but I got used to it as the movie progressed. I think the character was singing out of pain because the world that surrounded her was full of pain and sorrow. I think the singing was a way to mask that pain. I think. The girlfriend character was used as Alejandro's transition into the exercise of his mind. She opened up brighter and bigger possibilities for him, things of which he could have never expected. I had fun with this movie. It was bright, it was colorful, it was absurd, but I believe that it's a movie that has a poignant message. There are going to be people that keep you from doing the things that you love by either calling you names or just simply flat out telling you you can't do the things that you want to do. And usually it's the people that are closest to you, which is hurtful. But amongst all of the chaos, you must rebel. Because if true inventors or artists were to conform, then we wouldn't have been fortunate to have some of the greatest works of art and inventions that we have today. I give Alejandro Jodorowsky's Endless Poetry an A. I love this movie. What more can I say? There are things in it that did get under my skin, but if you can handle some absurd things in order to take in this movie's rich and powerful message, then I highly recommend watching this beautiful, entrancing film. So as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.